Today we are going to talk about Tulip Indicators. It is a library that allows you to calculate technical indicators like RSI, MACD, EMA or Bollinger Bands and all that. And the good thing about this wrapper is that you don't have to know the underlying math behind each of these indicators. So it offers you wrappers or inbuilt functions that you can leverage to automatically calculate the values for a particular indicator. Let's get started. Before we begin, here are some prerequisites. You need to have Node.js installed on your machine, and you should also have a basic understanding of JavaScript programming. This picture illustrates what the library does. So you would pass in the candlestick data on one end, and you would receive the corresponding indicator value on the other end. So this library serves like a black box, obfuscating the underlying math and giving us functions to automatically calculate the indicator values. This is the node package URL for this library, and this is the command to install this package in your project. So just copy that and go to your project and hit right click to paste the command and hit enter. It will take a couple of minutes to install. That's it. Installation is done. Enter CLS to clear screen. This is the GitHub link for this library. You can find the documentation for all the commands over here. Now that we've installed the package, let's get started with the demo. I'm going to create a new file called demo.js, and I'm going to import the library first. I'm also going to create a reference for console log so that I can reuse the command every time. First, in order to see the version of the library, you can log tulind.version. If you run it, you can see the version is 0.8.4. Now, in order to see the list of indicators supported by this library, you can say log tulind.indicators. Let me comment the previous statement and let's run it again. You can see that we get an array with a list of indicators supported by this library. You can see volume weighted moving average and Williams accumulation. So it supports quite a bit of indicators. In order to see the documentation for a particular indicator, to see what parameters are needed and how to use the function, you can say log tulind.indicators. Let's take RSI in this case. So if I hit RSI and if I run it, you can see the required documentation for this particular indicator. You can see that it has one input, one output, and here we get the data type for the input and the output. Without any further ado, let's get started with RSI indicator. So I'm going to create a new file. I'm just going to clone this for now. Okay. Now, in order to calculate indicators, I need candlestick data. So to do that, I'm going to use this API that returns the last 1,000 candles of BTC USDT on the 1 minute time frame. So I'm going to use this data to perform the analysis. So I'll just copy this. I'm going to create a new file, call it data.js and module.exports.data is equal to these values and save it. Now let's import the data over here, and if you look at the documentation, we need to pass the closing price, low, high and open price in the form of an array in the chronological order from the oldest to newest. So it should be in ascending order and chronological order. So let's extract this information from the data that we just copied. And if you look at the documentation for the candlestick data, you can see that this is how the data is organized. So in order to get the closing price, you can say require data.data.map d of, so fourth element is the closing price, so I'll say d of 4, and let's duplicate these. We need open, high, low and close. So open price is 1, high is 2, low is 3, close is 4. That's it. So we now have an array of all the price points of all the candlesticks. Now, in order to calculate the RSI value for this candlestick series, all you have to do is say tulint.indicators.rsi.indicator, and this takes in three parameters. First one is the input, and I'm going to use the closing price to calculate the RSI, so I pass the close array, and then I'm going to specify the length of the RSI. So if you look at the documentation, we can see we have to specify the period, so I'm going to put the length as 14, and then we're going to pass another function which is an asynchronous function that gets called once the candlesticks are processed. So it has two parameters, error and result. So if there is any error, we're just going to return that, and if there is no error, we're just going to log the response. Let's run it. You can see that we got the RSI values for the given candlestick series, and this is also sorted in chronological order. And to get the latest one, we have to look at the last item in this array. So we get slice of minus 1 of 0. So this returns the last element, which is the current, which is the RSI value for the current candle. So if I run it again, you can see that the RSI value for the current candle is 55.92. So it's as simple as that. So you pass the candlestick series and you specify the parameters, and we get the response back in the form of the result, in the form of this function. Now let's look at a simple moving average. So I'm just going to clone this, call it SMA, and everything is going to be the same. First, let me just comment this out, and let's look at the documentation for SMA indicator. So I'll just copy this and paste it here. I'll call it SMA, and let's run this node SMA. You can see that I can pass the closing price, open price, whatever series I want, and it only has one parameter, which is a period, which is the length of the moving average, and we get the response back in the form of an array, which is the moving average. So let's do that. I'll comment this out, and I'll uncomment this. Instead of RSI, we get SMA, and close. Let's get SMA 200, okay? And yeah, everything remains the same. So if I just run it, so this is a simple moving average, the last simple moving average. And if you want the entire series, then you just have to, instead of looking at the last element, just look at the entire value, entire array. Let's close this. Yep. So we get the entire series of the moving average. So if you have a requirement to plot these values on some charts, you can use the series as it is. Okay. So that's how you calculate simple moving average. Now we can do something similar for exponential moving average as well. So just clone it, and I'll call it EMA. And I think the parameters are going to be the same. So I'll just pass EMA instead of SMA, and let's get 21 period moving average. So I'll just pass 21. And if I just run this command, you can see we got the exponential moving average instead of simple moving average for the given series. So it's as simple as that. Now, let's take a slightly complex scenario where we have two results instead of one result. So let's just look at MACD, moving averages, convergence, divergence. So let me comment this out, and let's look at the parameters for MACD first. If I log it, you can see we only have one input, which is the series, open, close, or whatever it is. And then we have three parameters, which is a short period, long period, and the signal period. And then we get the result back in three arrays. So the first one is the MACD, the second one is the MACD signal, and the third one is the histogram. So let me open TradingView and show you exactly what these values are. All right, I've added MACD indicator over this chart, and you can see that the MACD plot has three price points, the blue line, the orange line and also the histogram. So these are the three results that this function returns, so that you can plot the values for each individual one of them. And you have to pass the short period. These are the three parameters. So if you just double click on this, you get to see all the parameters. You can see the fast length, slow length, and source is closed. Source we are anyways passing as the input parameter, so that's why it's not listed here. And then we have the signal smoothing, which is the signal period. So let's try to calculate that. So I'll just comment this out and I'll uncomment this. So instead of EMA, we would have MACD and the closing price and three lengths. So I'll just take the same lengths, 12, 26 and 9. Let's copy that, 12, 26 and 9. I guess these are the default values. And the response, we have three arrays. So if I look at response.length, if I log response.length, you should see a value of 3. Let's see that node. You can see the value of 3. So it returns three arrays. So if I just log the entire response, you can see it returns the values in the form of three arrays. It's not really visible on the command prompt, so I'll try to run it on in debug mode to show you exactly the values look like. So I'll just add an additional log statement so that I can put a breakpoint here. Alright, so I'll just keep it here and run it. Okay, if I look at response, you can see there are, this array has three different arrays inside it. So the first one is the MACD, and the second one is the slow length, the fast length, and the third one is the histogram length. So, you know, now that you have these values at your disposal, you can perform any kind of analysis that you want. You can use these for plotting charts or performing some kind of, you know, background analysis. So it's as simple as that. And finally, let's just look at one last indicator, which is parabolic SAR. So I'll just duplicate this one and I'll call it PSAR. Let me comment this out and let's look at the documentation for PSAR, which is parabolic SAR node. Okay, you can see parabolic SAR has two inputs, which is the high series and low series. And then it takes in two parameters, two options. One is accelerating factor step and acceleration factor maximum. So on TradingView chart, let me remove all the indicators and let's add SAR, PSAR, parabolic SAR. Yeah. And let's look at the parameters options for it. So you have a start, increment and max value. So we'll just put 0.02 and 0.2 and run this. Indicators PSAR, and here we pass, what do we pass? High and low. So high and low. Note that we already have the high, low and open and close series extracted at the beginning. So we'll just pass the high and low arrays, and then we have to pass two additional parameters here, which is 0.02 and 0.2, and then we get the response in the form of output is just one array. So if I log response.length, we should only see one value. Let's see that node PSAR. You can see the value is just one, and I'll just comment this out. And if you want to look at the last value, so just look at response of 0 dot slice minus 1. I'm just picking the last element of the array. That's it. So I'll just comment this out and let's log it again. Yep. So this is the value. This is the last parabolic SAR value for the last candle. So that's it. I wanted to cover simple indicators like RSI and moving averages. And I also wanted to cover complex indicators like MACD and PSAR, which requires multiple inputs and multiple outputs. So that you get a gist of how to use this library as a whole. And I've also created separate files so that when you download the code from GitHub, which I'm going to leave the link in the description box, it's easier for you to look at the code and implement this in your projects. So I hope you found this useful, and just leave your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. I'll talk to you guys very soon. Bye.